Good morning, children. Good morning, one and all. Welcome to DCEB Khammam and Suryapet YouTube channel. This is Krishna Priya, PGT Economics, TS Model School and Junior College, Anajipuram Village, Penpahad Mandal, Suryapet District. Before entering into the topic, once again, I would like to thank our DO sir, Sri P. Madan Mohan, and also the technical team who has created the district YouTube channel for online classes in COVID situation. It's my pleasure to teach through this channel. Thank you. So we are discussing about 9th class social studies second lesson, the natural rhythms of the earth. In the earlier class, we have discussed about the four great realms of the earth, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. Later, we also discussed about jigsaw puzzle, mainly the plate tectonics. So continuing the topic, today we are going to discuss about sea floor spreading, slow and sudden movements of the earth, and how the air and wind transform the surface of the earth. So, before entering into the topic, I'm going to share my screen. So students, in the last class, we have been discussed about plate tectonics. So plate tectonics is nothing but movement of plates on the earth surface happens in three directions: convergent plates, divergent plates, and transform plates. In the divergent plate, the two plates move away from each other, which gives scope for creation of rifts and also the seafloor spreading. Whereas the convergent of plates, that is the two plates are moving towards each other in opposite direction, which is giving scope for formation of mountains and also the volcanic eruptions. And the third form, it is transforming plates, where the two plates passes through each other in opposite direction, which leads to earthquakes. The first moment of the plate, it is divergent, under which we are going to study about how the sea floor spreads. So as the geologist found that there are mid-ocean ranges or ridges are a result of lava erupting from the mantle. These eruptions on the ocean ridges develops new ocean floor that is made up of basalt rocks. Later, the ocean floor spreads laterally from the ridge. This is the reason the mid-ocean ranges contain the newest crust formed on the planet. The newest crust is then slowly pulled away from the ridge, and thus the ocean basin gets widened. This results in the process of sea flow spreading. So students, on the surface of the earth, you find some hills and mountains, right? So like in the same wise, you can also find the ridges on the oceanic crust also. These ridges are nothing but the mountains or the hills on the oceanic crust. So these ridges which are found under the oceanic crust is due to the mountain which is moving this outer crust. Means these two plates are moving away from each other, which is giving scope for ridges at the middle of the ocean. When these two plates move away from each other, here is a scope for formation of newest crust. And these plates are pulled away from the ridge and the basin gets widened. This process is nothing but the sea flow spreading. When the sea is spreading, when the sea floor is spreading, what is happening at the margins of the sea? So there happens a drama. So drama at the margins. Just like the formation of the sea floor spreading along the mid-ocean ridges, the incoming plates goes under the static plate at the margins of the plates where they meet. Finally, the incoming plate goes into the mantle of the earth, becomes molten due to heat, for the rest of the plate is also pulled within it. In this process, it also pulls the new formed sea floor near the ocean ridges. So in this image, you can see this is the ridge area from which the two plates are moving away from each other. So this plate, when this plate is moving towards this direction, here you can see a static place where this plate is moving under into this static plate. Here you find the word trench. Trench is nothing but the deepest place in the oceanic crust. So like the deep valleys which you see on outer surface of the earth, likewise you can see the deepest valleys in the oceanic crust also. Those are called as trenches. So ridges are the hills and the trenches are the lowest places on the oceanic crust. So when this plate is moving towards this direction, the newest formed crust is also pulled away by this plate under the static plate. So likewise, the sea is going to widen or spread. So the slow and sudden movements of the earth. As we learned, there are two kinds of changes in the earth's lithosphere: slow movements and sudden movements. Slow movements lead to the formation of crust and continental plates, etc. Sudden movements like volcanoes and earthquakes that lead to destructions and huge changes in the landforms. So the slow movements of the plates give scope for formation of new landforms like mountains, deep valleys, plains, plateaus, etc., where the sudden movements of the plates give scope for volcanic eruptions and also the earthquakes. So let us have a look about volcanoes. So volcanoes are the places on the earth's surface where molten material from the mantle erupts on the earth's surface. This molten material is accompanied by steam, smoke and various forms of gases from the depths of the earth. The smoke, ash and dust spreads out in the atmosphere while the molten material cools and form hard rocks called igneous rock. So this is the structure of the volcano. So here the outer surface of the volcano is nothing but the lithosphere. So this lithosphere is floating on the upper layer of the mantle, that is called asthenosphere. So this molten material is coming out to the surface of the earth. When this molten material is going to come out, it looks to the roots to flow away from the surface of the earth. So this is called main wing and this is called the side winds, through which this molten materials come out from the volcano. So this molten material under the volcano is known as magma. When it is flows outside the surface of the volcano, then it is called as lava. So children, note that the molten material which is under the volcano is known as magma. When it's come out the surface of the volcano, then it is called as lava. So this molten material which is coming out from the surface of the volcano contains steam, smoke and various forms of gases and also ash and dust particles. So when the molten material which is coming out of the surface of the volcano cools down and form the hard rock called igneous rock. So this is all the igneous rocks which is cooled for the hundreds of years and later it formed as a hard rock called igneous rock. So there is a note, children. The term volcano came from the volcano island, which had been named after Vulcan, the Roman god of fire. So the eruptions of volcanoes give scopes for intrusive and extrusive landforms. So in the earlier class, we come across through the two different types of landforms. Those are first order landform and second order landform. Oceans and continents together said as first order landform. And due to internal process of the earth structure, the formation of mountains, plains, deep valleys, lowlands, oceans, etc. were called as second order landform. So the intrusive and extrusive landforms which are made up by the volcanic eruptions. Some part of the lava may not reach the surface and may cool under the surface and becomes rocks. These are called intrusive landforms. They are usually covered with older rocks and are exposed sometimes due to erosion of the covering rocks. A part of the lava which pours on the surface of the earth forms the extrusive landforms. Example, on Deccan, you can find formation of the extensive lava plateau. So there is a scope for intrusive landform and extrusive landforms made by the volcanoes. When the lava which is coming from the volcanoes may not reach the earth's surface, it gets cools down under the volcano itself. And those type of landform is known as intrusive landform. So this is the image. You can see the intrusive landform. So the lava is cooled down within the volcano itself. And this is exposed due to the erosion of the covering rocks. And some part of the lava which comes or pores on the surface of the earth is known as extrusive landform. And this lava, which is going to spread over a landscape, it is deposited as layer after layer, year after years. After a longer period, that is over the 100 years of time duration, you can see on the Deccan Plateau the extensive lava plateau, which is formed due to the intrusive landform. So this lava is cooled down for so many years and formed as a plateau. When the lava which cools down under the surface of the volcano is known as intrusive landform. When the lava which is cooled down outer the surface of the volcano is known as extrusive landforms. So there are some important volcanoes in the world. Those are Stromboli volcano, which is located in Sicily, Mount Pelee volcano, which is located in West Indies, Mount Vesuvius volcano, which is located in Italy, Mount Fujiyama volcano, located in Japan, Cotopaxi volcano, which is located in Ecuador, Mayon, which is located in Philippines, Barren and Narcodom volcanoes in India, Kilimanjaro volcano in Tanzania. So these are the real images of the important volcanoes in the world. So children, you have been noticed that in all places the earthquakes or volcanoes doesn't erupt. Only in some places frequently the earthquakes occur. Frequently the volcanoes erupts. Why such eruptions or earthquakes occurring only in those places? What is happening there? For example, we can see this is the area which is called as Pacific Ring of Fire. So this is the area on the image you can called as Pacific Ring of Fire, in which there is a frequent eruptions of volcanoes and frequent earthquake occurs. So why this is happening only in this region? Because this is the region where many of the major and minor plates meet together. So this is the Pacific Ocean boundaries, where many of the major and minor plates meets each other frequently. So there is a sudden movements of plates happens in this region, due to which there is a scope for frequent eruptions of volcanoes and occurring the earthquakes. That's why it is called as Pacific Ring of Fire. So the Pacific Ring of Fire is an area where large number of earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occur in the basin of the Pacific Ocean. High number of earthquakes and volcanoes occurs around the edge of the Pacific Ocean basin is called Pacific Rim. The Pacific Rim covers the western shores of North America, South America, Australia, and Eastern Asia and the Pacific Islands. So these are the regions where you can see the Pacific Rim. This is western shore of North America and South America and Australia. These are the western shores. And eastern shores of the Asia and also the Pacific Islands. Okay, children, now you got why there is a scope for frequent eruptions of earth volcanoes and earthquakes over this area. So moving to the external process in which the two major agents, that is wind and water, plays a major role to form the third order landforms. So the third order landforms are made by the two agents called wind and water. So due to internal process, the first order landform and second order landforms has been created on the Earth's surface, and due to external process, due to action of wind and water, we find some other landforms created on the Earth's surface which are known as third order landform. So in addition to the internal process, external process like the action of wind and water contribute a lot in the diversity of the landform. External process is how air and water work on the surface of the earth. The shaping of landforms by wind and water called third order landforms by geographers. These landforms include features like carved mountains, valleys, deltas, sand dunes, etc. So the processes like weathering, erosion, transportation, and deposition are largely responsible for these landforms. It is known as denudation process. So these third order landforms is formed due to denudation process in which weathering, erosion, transportation and deposition take place. So denudation is a continuous process. The lowlands, what we see today, were once mountains and plateaus. Yes, children. Yes, that is true. Whatever you have listened, that is true. The lowlands, what we are seeing today, were once upon a time, those are mountains and plateaus. But they are converted as lowlands due to denudation process. Don't you believe? Okay. In the next, that is in the continuation of this class and the next class, you will come to know how the wind and water transformed those mountains and plateaus into the lower plain. So whatever the landforms that you are seeing are continuously keep changing due to denudation activities. But these changes occurs very slowly. The structure of mountains, plateaus and plains keeps on changing through a process known as erosion cycle or geomorphic cycle. So the structure of mountains, plateaus and plains keeps on changing through a process known as erosion cycle or geomorphic cycle. So these four are responsible for formation of third order landform. It is known as denudation process. So let us have a look how air and water transform the surface of the earth through denudation process. So whatever the rocks we are seeing, those were formed out of the molten material coming from the mantle of the earth. These rocks, over millions of years, have been shaped into valleys and plains of loose soil, river valleys cut into mountains and plateaus, etc. Now, how did this happen? Can you imagine? So let us have a discussion about that. Actually, the hard primary rocks are broken into smaller pieces. These smaller pieces are cut off from the parent rock and carried lower down to other places and deposited there. This process is formally defined as weathering, erosion, transportation, and deposition. So let us study them in detail. First process is weathering. So weathering is a process by which the gradual disintegration of rocks by atmosphere forces or weather forces. The rocks, when exposed to heat, expands and contracts when they cools down. This happens every day during day and night and year after year in summer and winter seasons. As surface rock contracts and expands and contracts again, it gradually becomes brittle and begins to break down. Water and moisture in the air also help in this process. Water reacts with the chemicals of the rocks and further weakens the rock. This process by which the rocks are weakened and broken are called weathering. So, look at the large cracked rock and you will find that the color of the internal core of the rock is different from the outer layer. The color of the outer layer changes due to this process of weathering. So, this is called the weathering process. So, next it is erosion. Flowing water and wind have great power and can slowly wear away or cut away the rocks and soil cover in higher places. Water acts in many ways as rain, river, flowing groundwater, sea waves, glaciers, etc. Wind too takes many forms like storms, gusts, steady winds, etc. The active wearing away of the earth's surface by the moving these agents is called erosion. So the wind is eroding the upper surface of these rocks and water is eroding the upper surface of these rocks. This process is known as erosion of rocks by wind and water. So the next process is transportation. the eroded material in the form of small rocks, gravel, mud, fine soil, etc., carried by winds and water is called transportation. Rivers and winds and even waves cut the soil and rocks from one place and take them to distinct places, sometimes hundreds of kilometers. Yes, children, you believe it or not, the wind and water carries the eroded surface of the rocks and deposits them in distinct places. Maybe it is in hundreds of kilometers also. Next process of denudation is deposition. When the rivers and winds slow down, they do not have the force to carry the material anymore and they dump them. These dump derbies help to form plains and river basins. Much of it is actually transported by rivers to the sea, where layer after layer of these deposits accumulate at the bottom and over time get transformed into sedimentary rocks. So children, due to weathering process, the outer surface of the rock gets weakened and it is broken and eroded by wind and water and carried by them, and they are transported to other places with a great force. When they slow down, they don't have the capability to carry them, and they deposit all the sedimentary particles, that is sedimentary rocks which they hold, is deposited in other places. Example, a river which is carrying the sedimentary rocks, when it is flowing with full force, is deposited those rocks at the meeting of the sea, because it gets slowed down there. So all the carried sediments has been deposited on the seashore, and later the wind too acts in the same way. When it is blowing very forcefully, it carries all the sedimentary rocks and other particles with it. When it slows down at a particular region, it deposits all the sedimentary rocks and other contents over there. So due to which, the landforms will be, the new landforms will be created. So all four aspects of this process, that is weathering, erosion, transportation and deposition, are taking place simultaneously in different parts of the world at different rates. Depending on the nature of the slope, the structure of the rocks and the local climate and interference by humans. So students, depending on this class, I'm going to assign you some homeworks. To which you have to note down all the questions in your notebooks. So by observing this image, you have to write some few sentences and these are the some questions raised depending on the topic, and these are the choose the correct answer questions, and these are the fill in the blanks to which you have to answer in your notebooks. Okay, children, copy down the questions and answer them in your notebooks. So with this, I complete the second class for the lesson, The Natural Realms of the Earth. So this class will be continued in the next session. Thank you.